up this morning, smile with the rising sun, freely the bird. Fambul na salon, una good morning, good afternoon, Besna Emmanuel. Today mark the 14th day of September, this year of our Lord 2020. I would like to use this day as opportunity for talk to Sierra Leoneans them where they live at home and Sierra Leoneans them where they live na the diaspora. As yesterday marked the 13th of September 2020, there was a video where they come out from the SLPP party secretariat. Inside that particular video, we see some SLPP youth them being give out their griefs or opinion in relation with how senior party members them treat them. But my concern here about that particular video, now the comment where Sierra Leoneans at large they do in relation with that particular video, where I acknowledge say, many Sierra Leoneans them they laugh at that particular video, or they make certain statements them like, you know, they take that video as a form of something. Look, I would like for play this video. If you not been get the opportunity for watch this particular video, it's an opportunity now for make you watch this video. Then later I will come and tell you the catastrophe, calamity, or the things them we hang in the lives of Sierra Leoneans them we relate that particular video or the statement them we those SLPP youths them make into that particular video. Take a chance and view this particular video for yourself whilst I will come and explain to you what in the behind that particular video. Take a look for yourself.
You see, don't show to you say,
you
don't begin to say we for value yourself. You don't go can let come pass yourself. Watch, I say, some people will be sure so. We already are a soldier, team, the frontline soldier. We don't pay test that if not, I watch a revenge. No different person is in a week.
So no more over there.
No mission on the arena. Where they can't find some people, not to force the guys to kids. We still go buy elections there. We ready. We don't go back confessional. We still at least one office and at the office with us.
That now in the said video we all don't take a look at. But my concern here about that particular video now the statement them way I say Sierra Leoneans at large then they make you know form out of their statement and they. We see them guys who inside the SLPP party secretariat where they hold allegiance to the SLPP and these are these contributes them of the SLPP where don't feel neglected, they don't feel like they have been abandoned recklessly by the SLPP big guns them now the country. You know, in the statement then they make two keywords where like I want to take your time, make you pay attention into the two keywords they are. One, this is going to SLPP youth them cry say, no job for them, that they don't abandon them recklessly, they don't shed blood for the SLPP party. Then the other thing again where they make a statement like it's like a true confession, then they tell people them, the bad things them always been happening to them by elections them at the country, put the country to, unrestful situation into them by elections they did that. Now them been the one in the name of SLPP. That they don't tell me inside them particular video. I mean inside this particular video. But it's like, the job where them guy are the seek for, me and you two go attest to this fact say, then guys will be get a job. But because of these, you know, state of emergency where the president put now the country or the corona pandemic where the president tell we say they now the country, the job don't stand at ease. You know, everything don't become so, still. It don't so stagnatic that they not get this job again waiting for the do into this by-elections them like. When there's a by-election, they will see Tom Kolimba, then go, then create violence there. We see another constituency 110, then go there, then create violence thing, then go a lot of places them. Then Gaya, so they go and create violence then in the name of the SLPP. So now this job not there for them again. So what thing they ask for, when me and you to know from a logical point, these guys are seeking for them to be empowered by key state actors them. Then they cry to them for make them go empower them. Now, I go want for make you go be rest assured see. Come next year, you go see them guy also, them wear military uniform or them wear OSD uniform. And these are the guys them where go get that opportunity, they wear military uniform or wear OSD uniform, they go around in certain places, them where Sierra Leoneans, then they come out say, they set one for give up their own views or opinion or their own democratic rights for protest. Now then guys so them would use for go around in the places they are and gun our brothers and sisters down, like what happened in Pademba Road, what happened in Makeni, Lonshar, and other places in the Republic of Sierra Leone. So do not be in that doubt if you see them guys who wear police uniform in the name of OSD or military uniform, they go around and they kill people there because they already don't cry out for them to be empowered. Okay, let me leave that particular part, say then we're going to the police or into the army. Let's look at it again in this other way. If by any means they're not going to the police or the army, there's another job again for them where the SLPP go get them. In politics, we get people that we call the political assassin. That political assassin, they are now people where these guys themselves, or the in Africa setting, then they bring themselves one kind of way, like, or present themselves as if they are armed robbers. You understand? Thief, minded. Now, so they present themselves like they are thief minded. Now, next, sometimes because Mr. B no support Mr. A way they into incumbent, or people not support this SLPP because they call things by their name. People not agree for support this SLPP into their devious and bad deeds. They not agree for dance to that tune of that cultic institute within the country now in the name of power, where many people they disagree to them with. Or those where they blow out that trumpet that murder bill must go come 2023. They don't unite them people them here, they don't mark them. Our honorable parliamentarians them. Our main opposition helps them as we don't get, SLPP youth person, when are the grassroots youth leaders, we don't talk to them, we'll go after our leaders. They will kill them. Who can tell that then this gun to use their way cry say they want job, they can easily give them this political assassin job. When it comes, our leaders then go to sleep, then go, then broke them, then doors them, enter and then doors them. And in any given community or in any given locality, let me tell you this, they get what they call the local unit commander, that thing where they say the LUC, within any community, the LUC can easily tell or instruct a man them say, tonight, then when they call, say, una come, let nobody know come out, not to true, not to this. You don't instruct them. Whilst they don't put this as a plan together, then political assassins don't dress themselves as if they are armed robbers. Go on and let, broke the doors of our leaders then, go kill them. Then go present themselves, say, okay, they don't do the killing. Then go make like say, then go for good thief, then take some property then, go away. But at the end of the day, their assignment or their motive now for go there and kill. They don't do the killing. You will feel say, oh, now thief man then come for can thief, now let we call police. Now later on police then come. No. This now a gimmick something. This is what these youths are crying for them to be empowered. Today, we know they get by elections them, for make them or put them works them together. We know they get again them by elections they have for let them go cause me harm. We know they get them by elections they have for make them go kill people them. Go take box them, lift them up and destroy ballot papers them, where people them don't vote. Either they go to the police, they go to the army, or they become political assassins as stiff-minded manettes. Kill we leaders then. So I want to encourage you and implore you as you don't view that particular video. It is not something we for laugh at. It is not something we for mock at, say, oh, SLPP people for provide jobs. They have a lot of jobs for provide for their youth then. As long as it's concerned negativity, they have negative jobs to create for their youths. So we should not take this thing to laugh at it. We should not mock at this thing. So I want to employ you. If you yearly at any given time now, from now to next year, or let me put this into practice. If you never cry, say unakamo titi, let me get into that self-vigilante form. Let me come out and help our neighbors. Let me prepare ourselves. Let me stand together. With them particular videos there, them particular statements there, it is something we should not take light. It is something we should not mock after. It is something we should not laugh at. But believe it me, as I said, there are serious calamity and serious catastrophe or problem we hand into the lives of our people back home with short statement into that particular video. These guys are asking the SLPP heads to empower them. If me and you today fool we self say the guys they not been get job, they get job. But the guy then don't tell we authoritatively say them been they do so for the SLPP. They don't call them in different by-elections, them they don't cause problem then they. So this is a giving opportunity with short statement for me we put we self together in a vigilante form. If you hear you never cry the net, come out and help your neighbor. Let's be our brother's keepers. I bring you this message in peace, and I want to let you in peace. Remember, say this message come to you under the courtesy of the rising sun. Me will bring you this message. My name is Emmanuel. Plenty thank you. God bless you as you disseminate this message. Stay safe and stay blessed. Once more again, God bless you and God bless Mama Salo. Thank you.